Ah, input. We can't make a game without it. You press a button and stuff happens on screen. How fun! Our job as game engine developers is to make it clear for the game devs using our engines to read and react to input however they want. Well, for me, it's my job to make my job easier, since I'm both the engine dev and the game dev. What I wanted was simplicity. Even if the game builds layers on top of the input, like filling a queue with inputs and executing them later, that's the task for gameplay code. The engine must make it easy to read the input, and most importantly, correctly interpret the signals. I do plan to make this a bit more abstract once I make the controller support, but right now, and for the current game, I plan a PC-only release. For our current simple setup, our inputs are keyboard keys, and mouse position. These three make up the core of what will be processed. All this will be really simple thanks to the window manager I use. GLFW has very handy callbacks we can hook into to get info about input events that are being sent from the OS to the window. With keys, we care about three states: pressed, held, and released. The pressed and released are only kept for a single frame, when the action happened. The held state is kept throughout the frames on which we're still pressing the button until we release it. So, we create keyboard input shared data struct, which holds three unordered sets for the different states the keys can be in. We can then hook this into the GLFW key callback, and based on the action performed, either when pressed, add the key to pressed and held, or when released, remove from held and add to released. The same is for mouse input shared data struct. We just hook it into the mouse button callback. Mouse position is just the current mouse position, which changes when a mouse moves, and is kept the same after, and mouse position delta, which is the difference in mouse position between two frames. We create a shared data struct called mouse position and keep two-dimensional vectors for position and delta. Then, when we hook it into mouse pos callback, which interestingly gets called only when the mouse moves, we save the new mouse position and calculate the mouse delta based on current position minus previous position. And that's it, right? We just have the input ready. Sadly, no. If you've noticed, we only ever fill the data. We don't clear it. And some of the states, as mentioned previously, should live only for the given frame they're activated in. The strategy I decided on is to gather input at the beginning of the frame, and then at the end of the frame, just perform a simple cleanup. We clean up the press and released keys, and the mouse delta, because at that point it should already all be checked and processed during the frame. So, let's gather what we've seen here. At the start of the frame, we tell GLFW to check if any inputs happened. If they did, GLFW calls our custom callbacks, filling our shared data structs with the current state of the inputs. We can process anything we want by just requesting them from the shared data system, and do whatever we want. Then, at the end of the frame, we clear the frame-specific inputs. But I can't just leave you without showing you how it works. I hooked the input into the editor and made a really simple camera controller with it. Oops, what is this? Is this the beginning of some gameplay happening here? That's for later. Right now, as we can see, the camera moves, and I can fly freely around my level. If you enjoyed this dive into the inner workings of my game engine, be sure to like and subscribe. I thank you very much for watching, and be ready for a more abstract video next time about my issues with the S in ECS. Bye!